indicted Samuel Jones for the murder of 21-year-old Laau Jordan Laulusa, who was found in a burning car at Mililani High School on Monday. Prosecutors tell us this is a domestic violence case. Tonight, an ex-girlfriend of Jones is speaking out to say there were some troubling signs in the relationship, things she brought up in a restraining order request. Manolo Morales has more.
Before Jones met Laulusa, he went out with another woman who agreed to speak to us if she could stay anonymous. She went out with him for 3 years, and she says he showed a dark side that not many others saw.
It took me a year to see the signs. It took me another year to convince myself to get out of it. And then it took me the year after that to actually get myself out of it.
She says it started out like many other relationships, but then he started telling her more and more of what she can and cannot do.
It started getting more controlling to where I couldn't wear shorts without him being with me.
She says the breaking point was when she said she wanted to leave him.
He just straight up looked at me and was like, if you try to leave me or if you succeed in leaving me, I'm gonna find you and kill you.
Not long after that, when he went on a trip, she filed a temporary restraining order against him, which a judge granted, and she left him for good. The woman tells us she feels terrible for the Laulusa family. She wishes she could have warned them about Jones, which could have prevented a tragedy.
To know that Jordan's mom is mourning her daughters, it hurts my heart.
Domestic violence experts say such behavior presents big red flags in a relationship.
That kind of control lays the foundation for isolation, intimidation, threats.
Creedman says control and isolation make it harder to leave the relationship. That's why it's important to get help.
Just know that they can talk this over with a domestic violence program and make some plans for themselves or set some boundaries.
Jones's former girlfriend hopes her story inspires others to get out of a bad relationship and get help from family and outside agencies. Manolo Morales, KHON 2 News.
Man, we back with another crazy story, man, about a 21-year-old U.S. military soldier who was found stabbed in the neck in the car, burnt in a high school parking lot. You know what I'm saying? And this was our so-called boyfriend who supposedly committed the crime. I mean, he was already controlling. You know what I'm saying? Look at him, you know. The ex said it took a couple years for him to fade out into the person that he really is. So that lets you know what type of dude he is. See what I'm saying? He already threatened somebody, I'll kill you. You know, unfortunately, you know, Miss Jordan just was the one who got killed in this situation. You know, the ex-female, his ex-girlfriend got away. But it was the same situation. Then he done went on and killed somebody else's daughter, somebody else's sister. You know what I'm saying? We in our last days, people committing crimes that shouldn't be committed. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you ain't strong enough to just walk away from the situation, you know, then you don't deserve to be with nobody. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just senseless crimes going on, man. That's why I say we in our last days and this stuff just gonna continue. Because this the type of day and age we in. These type of crimes starting to become normal. You know what I'm saying? People killing themselves, killing their family, killing their girlfriends. But you know what I'm saying? Like I said, you know, you take people's life, your life deserves to be taken. You know, she had a lot ahead of her. Like I said, she was, you know, moving materials and shit for the base. You know, and they said they met a couple weeks before, so that everything was moving pretty fast. You don't know nobody in a couple weeks. You know, and something went down, and, you know, he just snapped. You know, but he gonna pay for that. You know what I'm saying? He gonna spend the rest of his life in prison. But like I said, it's just another crazy situation. Like I said, just watch the people that you meet, anybody new that you're around, because you don't know what their intentions is. You know, these stories keep coming up, the same thing. You know, you meet somebody, they get more personal, or they hiding who they really are. And then, you know, months and years down the line, you start seeing who the person really is. And by then, it's too late. So like I said, you know, this world is just controlling right now, with people just doing all type of crimes, all type of stuff, you know. But like I said, you know, prayers goes out to our family. You know, justice will get served. We're in our last days. You know, everybody protect themselves. Let me know what y'all think about this crazy story, man. Too many people losing their life, young people. You know, life snatched away from them. But let me know what y'all think about this crazy story, man. We out. Pow. Cause every day it's getting
colder. And if only I could. That's our vlog. And today, this morning, we are getting ready. Sugar is ready already. We're just getting ready. There she is.